Hi, I'm Jan with the community team at Mendix. Thank you for tuning in to the first Mendix release video, where we bring you up to date with the highlights of the latest Mendix release. This release has three new features that we'll cover in this video. The first is a set of improvements for data constraints. The second is improvements to expressions for conditional formatting. And the third is improvements to hybrid app publishing. Let's get started with our first topic, data constraint improvements.
Hi there, I'm Yevgen with the Data Stories team. In this release, we added functionality that will improve the performance of enterprise-scale unique constraint validations. What this means is that your unique constraints will now be handled by the database instead of Mendix runtime. You will notice performance improvements when you make use of concurrent microflows, when you commit associated objects, and when you commit objects with unique attributes. When you open your existing projects in Mendix 7.3, you will have the option to update your projects to the new data validation method. You can change this in your project settings. New projects will use this behavior by default, so you can benefit from this improved functionality out of the box. The previous unique constraint validation functionality offered the flexibility of not having to migrate production data when making small changes to the business rules in your application. If you have benefited from this in the past, you will now be notified that you can't deploy your app until you have migrated your data. Contact Mendix support to get a hold of a simple visual tool that can help you do this.
Thanks, Yevgen. We have also added some new functionality to client-side expressions in Mendix, which Mitya will tell you more about.
Hi there, I'm Mitya with the WebCore team. Since we introduced client-side expressions in Mendix 7.1, we promised to fill the gap between what you can do server-side and client-side. In this release, we are making another step in this direction by introducing string function to the client-side. These client-side expressions are a major step forward for the Mendix platform because they greatly simplify your modeling experience. For example, think of a situation where you want to show a warning indicating that the password is not strong enough to users who are setting up a new password. You can now easily show or hide the warning based on an expression instead of using a dedicated virtual attribute and on change microflow. This solution saves you a lot of modeling time and provides a better user experience because the interface reacts to users' actions instantly. Our goal is to keep extending client-side expressions with every Mendix release, so stay tuned for more.
Thanks, Mitya. We've also focused on improving our mobile offering and released some great new functionality. Denny will tell you more about this.
Hi there, I'm Denny from the mobile team at Mendix. In this release, we added some great improvements to hybrid app publishing. Next to support for splash screens for the latest mobile devices, we added more settings to the cloud portal that will make it easier to build and publish your hybrid apps. You can now configure whether the app should ask for a PIN. You can do this in the mobile app settings page by checking the PIN required option. You can also specify whether your app is an offline capable app so that it can run without an internet connection. We have also added the option to switch off the permissions that your app requires, like access to your location, your camera, and your photo library. And finally, you can add your own custom phone gap configuration so that you can easily add plugins and custom app settings. These new settings allow developers to build a mobile app with phone gap built without extensive technical expertise. A more technical change we implemented is the do-it-yourself option, which allows you to easily extend your hybrid app, create multiple versions, and update the hybrid app. You can check out the Mendix documentation for more information.
Thanks, Danny. That covers the highlights for this release. To learn more, check out the release blog on mendix.com/blogs and the release notes on docs.mendix.com. Thank you for watching, and see you at the next release.